morning, everybody. First of all, many thanks to the organizing committee for this kind invitation and to Enrico for organizing this session. I'm Anna Costa. I come from an Institute of Science and Technology for Ceramics from CNR in Italy. So I will show you my our material scientist approach to designing safe nanomaterials. So I will start this presentation showing you some safety nanodesign concepts. Then I will briefly introduce the SANOVOR project and the SANOVOR design options developed in the project to assess the risk management of nanomaterials. As an example, I will show you some results referred to one of the target materials, silver nanosol, involved in one of our six processing lines, following some conclusion. So if we look to the traditional containment hierarchy of controls applied to the risk management of chemicals, we can see that the safe nanodesign concepts stay at the top of the hierarchy because the aim is to design out risks rather than address them when they occur. So the safety nanodesign concepts mainly are applied to the design of safer nanomolecules and the design of safer nanomanufacturing process. Of course, the strategy developed should address the big challenge to find an equilibrium between benefit and cost. The main goals of SANOVOR project, here are shown some identification details, are to develop design-based risk remediation strategies, to integrate them in real manufacturing processing line, and to evaluate them by implementing an exposure assessment methodologies in the workplaces, performing risk analysis before and after the introduction of such modification strategies, and analyzing cost benefit on the basis of risk analysis results and nanomaterials performance. The main SANOVOR design options developed are surface coating by organic amphiphilic molecules or silica coating, and the process of micronization or immobilization by gel coating, impregnation on porous inorganic structure that aims to create protective layers that decrease health hazard or biological exposure potential in the case of coating, and to create stabilized structures that decrease emission potential and improve nanoproduct recovery and disposal in case of immobilization strategies. Of course, all these design options should preserve the nanoscale reactivity. So here are shown two of colloidal techniques used to apply such strategies. In one case is the electrostatic, the heterocoagulation between different charged surfaces. In this case, the spray drying of nanosols that presents several advantages in comparison to chemical strategies used for functionalized nanoparticles. All these colloidal techniques are cost-effective, easy to apply, quick to perform. There is an absence of chemical byproducts because there is an absence of chemical reaction, and they are industrially easily scalable. All criteria that match very well with the aim of the project, that is to develop practical strategies to be implemented in the processing line. So I will show you some preliminary results referred to one of our processing lines, the processing line 5. The industrial scenarios and materials are later available by Colorobia. And the line is referred to the application of silver and titanium nanosols for the functionalization of ceramic substrate by spray coating. So we have identified one critical steps for the potential of exposure, for the potential of nanoaerosolization, And we have identified two exposure scenarios, one before where uncoated nanomaterials are processed, and one after where coated nanomaterials by silica citrate, gelatin, or micronized nanomaterials are processed. So if we look to silver silica system, we can see that we start with silver nanosols, and we made a silica functionalization by heterocoagulation and as comparison by chemical silica nucleation on silver nanoparticle seeds. Then both the pristine and modified soils are spray dried and redispersed with and without the silica. So we have identified in this case two pristine samples, two pristine samples from commercial soils that are silver and silica soils, and different modified samples. We can see some FEG image of silver nanosols formed by nanoparticles with diameter ranging from 20-60 nanometers. We can see the blear effect due to the presence of organic coating that was confirmed to be PVP. If we look to the DLS analysis, we can see that the presence of silica significantly improves the silver nanodiameter only with the sample where silica is coated by nucleation, whilst the such an improvement of diameter is not detected in the sample by heterocoagulation, because maybe the presence of capping agent masks the silica coating, and so we don't see the improvement of diameter, or the presence of PVP coating can prevent the heterocoagulation, as in this case it schematized. We can also see the structure of spray dried samples, where are detected spherical micro, as expected, are detected spherical micrometric secondary particles with holes due to the collapsing of salts or inorganic phases present in the pristine nanosols. If we look to time images of heterocoagulated and silica nucleated samples, we can see what we expected on the basis of DLS results. So in the case of heterocoagulated samples, actually nanoparticles are dispersed in a matrix of silica, whilst the formation of core shell structure is only detected in the silica nucleated samples. If we look to the same images of redispersed sample in the presence or not of silica, we can see that all the redispersed spray dried powders return in the colloidal form with a dispersibility that is better in the presence of silica. Such a result is very good from a point of view of the process, because the redispersion of spray dried powders is very important because it allows to handle micrometric powder that are safe, stable, of course, and to reobtain nanosols when desired. I try to summarize some results, some biological results from University of Parma that are well explained in a poster that you can see outside. So the main results that we obtain are that all tested nanoparticles caused a significant loss of viability, whilst the pristine silica nanosol does not show any significant effect on cell viability. The cell viability of pristine and silica heterocoagulated soils is comparable. So at the level of soil, we cannot say that silica has made a remediation of toxicity of pristine samples. A mitigation effect actually was detected at the beginning of the project on spray dried powders, independently by the presence or not of silica coating. Nevertheless, once corrected for the actual silver content, once measure and consider that spray dry sample contain at least 50% of organic phase, we found that no significant difference was found between pristine and modified samples. Finally, the silver ions weight ratio was detected for all analyzed samples, and the bioreactivity of silver ion solution used as reference, as the concentration of silver ions found in the nanosols gave the same results in terms of cell viability, such indicating a reactivity totally dependent by the silver ions concentration. So, on the basis of these results, we remodulate the models of the materials that we characterize. So, at the beginning, the starting model on the basis of a commercial technical sheet is one of a nanosol with a concentration of 4%, where the silver ion concentration expected by surface leaching is less than 1% referred to the total concentration of silver, so about 0.04%. Once measured, the silver ions content by elemental analysis performed by XRF, we found that the silver ions concentration results about 50% referred to the silver total concentration, so about 2% on the volume. So this was explained due to the presence of unreacted precursors. Finally, when we performed thermal analysis on spray-dried powders, we found that the sample contained about 60% of organic additives that were added during the synthesis, so before the company provided us the samples, to control, of course, particle growth and powder dispersibility. So, on the basis of these results, it's clear that the surface coating we designed, we planned by organic or inorganic additives could not have effect because the large amount of silver ions present will always prevail on silver nanoparticles' reactivity. As well, the presence of this large amount of organic coating prevents the expected silica attachment by heterocoagulation. So we start to modulate also new strategies. In this case, one strategy could be the immobilization on clay substrate, for example, that is just used in some of these applications, followed by washing out the silver ions in order to decrease the acute toxicity and assess the antibacterial efficiency of the product. In this case, we can think to the introduction of cross-linking agents, like for example silane compound, that can improve the silica attachment. So, for concluding, the nano-design concepts in general open new challenges towards the creation of nanotechnology that satisfy performance and safety requirements. The project SunWorks is based on risk remediation strategy and on design option based risk remediation strategy, and wants to integrate such strategies within real industrial processing lines. I showed you some preliminary results on physical, chemical, and biological characterizations that open some dosimetric issues and suggest new strategies to address the risk remediation. So my acknowledgements go to the Nanotechnology and Colloidal Process Group at ISTEC, to the SunWorks Consortium, to the European Community for funding this research, and of course to you for your attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Anna, for your interesting talk. There is time for a couple of questions. Michael?
Thank you for this nice talk. I missed at the beginning maybe the point why you have identified this coating as a key process to improve your overall system. How did you identify that this should be addressed?
Well, the coating is was proposed to control the exposure and the health effects of nanomaterials. From the point of view of the process, of course, has been selecting a coating that cannot prevent the efficiency functionality of the products. The silica, for example, the silica coating on silver nanoparticles has been also proposed to increase the efficiency of the product, because silica makes like a sort of layer that control the ions drug delivery at the basis of antibacterial effect. So if I understand your question, the risk remediation strategy that we propose looks both to the efficiency of the product, the functionality of the product, and to the risk remediation effects. Sure. No. Okay, thank you.
Now, it means that sometimes when you open the door, you can have at least different door closed. So since this project is based on the development materials and to assess point by point, time by time, the hazardous properties, maybe that the goal identified in the first at the first time was correct as believed, as generally believed. So this the material sciences should take into account also the needs from the companies in developing effective materials, not only completely the safety issues, but also the company needs. Other questions?
Jacques Bouillard, Niaris. I was wondering whether, I thought originally Sanowork was to protect workers, because there's a worker there, right?
Yeah.
So if we stand just on that, in terms of safety, you just have to put safety barriers, classical safety barriers of extraction systems or what have you on your workplaces. No matter, I mean, it doesn't really depend whether your silica is coated or not or what have you.
Yeah.
And, but now I think you go even further than that. You go on what is really the biological activity of the particle itself. So that's another question regarding to your users.
Actually.
Well, so I don't know where you stand.
Thank you, Jacques. Actually, the Sanowor project was funded under a topic that was worker exposure risk management. But at the beginning of the development of this proposal, we focused on a safety by design approach that was one of the claimed goals of such topic. It was at the first place of the goals expected from these projects, and I think that was one of the reasons that for the funding of this project, because safety by design approach, as I shown you before, when show you the hierarchy of controls, is actually at the top of any hierarchy of any containment measures. Of course, it's quite far from the final effect that you expected, and I agree with you. But anyway, is a starting point to approach the risk management of materials from a material scientist point of view. Of course, the hazard characterization and exposure characterization are important, because we need to validate such strategies. So is not to go out from the original aim, but is to support our original approach. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Anna.
So I will introduce the next speaker, that is Enrico, that will speak about a biomonitoring approach to assess the risk management, so the exposure and the health effects control of nanomaterials. I'm sorry, I I will not be able to stay until the end of the session. I have a flight at 3 o'clock. Thank you again for your attention. And,